Jake, welcome back to the show.
Wow, that was so nice.
That was nice. We have a great. They love you.
That was so nice.
We love you. Yeah.
Felt like Billie Eilish or something.
No, yeah, no, you. welcome back to the show. We were talking backstage because you've been on our show. We've done the Tonight Show for 10 years now, which seems like just yesterday we started. But even before then, we were doing late night. And you were doing bits with us.
Yeah.
So thank you for being a great guest and a good friend to the show. We love you.
I was thinking about it. Like now that you're like totally certified and you're a legend in that way, you know, it was so cool to be there with you at the beginning of it all. I mean, even when you're on SNL and stuff,
that's
I remember
right.
your first year.
That's yeah, right. Yeah, actually, yeah. we've known each other for a long time.
A long
right?
time. Yeah. Yeah.
I want to talk to you about this. I think you're good with live audiences. You're good. You love this applause. It works well together. And here's why. You're coming back to Broadway, by the way. This is a big deal. This is a giant deal.
Yeah.
You like live theater. This is...
Oh, I mean, I love it. I mean, it's like, in the same breath, it's enriching and incredible and terrifying at the same time. So it's so great.
Yeah. There's no safety net. Yeah.
Nothing.
You're coming back in a big way. You're going to star in Shakespeare's Othello. Are you kidding me? With none other than Denzel Washington. Come on!
Yeah.
How awesome is that?
I know. So sweet. What a great crowd.
This is mad. It's fun, all right? Well, come on. Just first of all, just doing Othello on Broadway.
I know it's crazy. Well, first of all, it's Shakespeare, which is one thing, and then it's with Denzel Washington, which is the whole other thing. It's
so you like a lot of you like pressure. You're adding this into your life.
I mean,
you're choosing this.
Yeah, I mean, in a way, like you got to walk into a situation, particularly on the stage, or when you're going to delve into something for that long, where you know you're going to learn. You know, you want to learn, and I don't know if there are any two better people to learn from than Shakespeare and Denzel Washington.
Yeah. Are you intimidated at all, or just excited?
Yeah.
I mean, maybe he's intimidated too. I mean, I think you're. I mean, I see this as a giant, this is going to be so fun.
I got to tell you, it really is a dream. I mean, I obviously have been, like, he's been an idol of mine. Like, I've just looked up to him for years. So to be able to be on the stage with someone like that is just, it's a dream come true. And Kenny Leon, too, who's directing it, is incredible also. So
it's going to be fantastic.
And William Shakespeare, who I went to high school with, is just.
No, I love Billy. Billy Shakespeare.
Billy
Shakespeare is.
Like, he really is. He's a great guy.
He's going to go somewhere.
I think
he's
going to. Feel.
I would lose the collar thing, but besides that, it's like a fad.
But I feel like he's getting there, and he's really a talent.
Yes, yes, he's something. Yeah. I don't know. It's
really
just...
So anyway, I'm excited for him.
Me too. It's like a hopefully it works out. If not, it's going to be a tragedy. thank you very much. Please, no standing ovation. No, oh, my God. Standing ovation. Thank you very much. That's how you do it.
I remember. Really.
We just got... And we got to go to commercial. Oh, my gosh. So bad.
I think I've laughed here more than I've talked here. Over the years, I've laughed at this desk more than I've ever talked.
Good. That's the way it should be. But what a great, fun job that we have. But also, you can do Othello, you can do Shakespeare on Broadway, but also do Roadhouse. I mean, that's so fun. Wait till you see this. It is so fun. It's exactly what I wanted to do. But how do you even come across, like, oh, let's redo Roadhouse.
Doug Lyman, who directed the movie, has been a friend. He's the best. We've been friends for 15 plus years, maybe longer than we've been friends.
Yeah.
And we've tried to find a movie to do throughout that time, and like we've sort of tried to, but it didn't really work out. And then we were at dinner one night talking about something else, and he said, "I read this draft of this reimagining of Roadhouse," and before he could like finish the word house, I was like, "That sounds crazy. Let's do that."
Like,
I was like,
why?
That's a terrible idea. Let's do it.
It turns out great.
And it was just like something about making a movie with your friend, something about, you know, being in that world. I knew Patrick Swayze when made Donnie Darko with your incredible wife, Nancy, who produced that movie.
That's right. This is look at you and Patrick Swayze. What was he like?
I mean, he was just the kindest, most... I mean, he supported me very early on. I mean, him and his wife, Lisa, just so sweet. Like, just always there. And
I mean, every movie. I mean, come on. Dirty Dancing.
Point Break.
Point Break.
Ghost.
I mean, the guy's...
It's just like, so...
Crushes it.
Yeah. So, like, I love that, the original movie and the thought of redoing it just sounded like a lot of fun.
You know? You think he would love this? I think he would love this.
I think he would.
If you liked Roadhouse, and you're going to dig this, but you got jacked. I've seen you jacked before. I've seen you, like, in great shape. You were the boxer. It was a boxing
movie. Yeah.
But this one is next level. Dude.
Well, I...
Look at this. Is this CGI, or what am I looking
at? That's some...
That's it, yeah. The photo... The photo got an ow! That's the review. All the reviews are like, ow!
That's all you need.
But I've never seen anyone have 13 abs. I mean, what? How is it possible? I mean, the training that goes into this.
There was a lot of training, but when I got word that, because Conor McGregor's in the movie with me, and when I got word that he was going to be doing it, I was super psyched because they chased him for a long time to play the part. But then I got totally terrified, and I thought, oh, God, I actually have to fake fight this guy, and I got to look like I can. So we trained for, I stay in pretty good shape, but we trained for 2 months pretty hard, grappling, a lot of MMA, and then also just, getting in shape, you know?
And then you showed up at a UFC fight. To film a scene, it was a scene announcing that you're actually going to get in the ring and blah, 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 and no one knew you're going to be there.
No, yeah.
That would make me nervous.
Yeah, that was pretty nerve-wracking. They had never allowed anyone who wasn't a fighter into the ring, and I had that pictures, I'm wearing the UFC shorts, and it has my character's name on it and stuff like that. And
did anyone know what was going on there?
No, we surprised an audience of 15,000 people after the undercards, before the main event. We were given a certain amount of time and to shoot this sequence, this little piece of a fight sequence. And I entered in and everyone was like, who is this person? And and then they kind of got that we were fake fighting, but they were still cheering. You know, they would I would throw a fake punch, they'd go, it'd go crazy, 15,000 people. It was insane.
They're acting in the movie with you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But you're in the octagon. I mean, I get nervous just even watching this.
So serious. So serious. So serious.
Another ow. And Conor McGregor's fantastic, by the way.
Oh, yeah. He's so,
it's perfect. He's great.
It's crazy.
I hung out with him once on the show. We went to a thing, and he had something with his whiskey. We went to a bar, and I was frightened. Because you never know when all of a sudden something's he doesn't understand a joke or something. He's like, what? And then just knocks you out. Dude, I don't want any of this.
It's all a possibility, yes.
Did you get close, when you were fighting and stuff?
Yeah. We had, by mistake, he clocked me in the face, but only when we would do a take where we're fighting and fake fighting, and then we'd go watch the monitor to see it back, to see what worked, and he was always great with me. He would show me, tell me to do things and turn your hand, move a little bit more this way to try and make it look more real. And it was late because we shot a lot of these fight scenes at night. So it was 3 a.m. And he was talking to me really close and he was like, yeah, so that left hook looks good, but then when you do it, boom, like that. And he hit me by mistake. It was almost like, I was like, oh,
he's bleeding. I'm bleeding. I'm an actor. I'm an actor. I'm on Broadway. Don't talk, this is the money!
The face!
That's it.
And but I, by mistake, then slammed his face with a car door. And he was
he's like, that's funny.
Legit, hit his face. He was like...
Yeah, he's like, that tickled me. It tickled me, yeah. And Post Malone, by the way, a little acting chops.
So great, so great.
Good music in this. It's just a fun ride. Action, but it's also fun. You know what it is. It's Roadhouse. I mean, do we got to set it up?
It's so much fun. If you want to have fun, you want to see a great movie, laugh a lot, watch great fights, great action, watch Conor McGregor in his movie debut.
Yeah.
I don't know. There's so much great stuff in it, so no intro.
I want to show you a clip. Here's Jake Gyllenhaal in Roadhouse. Take a look.
Logan!
What?
It's about time! That's what! You know I got sent here special.
Just for you.
Well, you brought all your friends with you?
I told you my miss having an audience. I was trying to be thoughtful. Like on pay-per-view. 25 quid. Watch me pump your face!
Well, I guess I'm gonna lose then.
Don't be like that. Here, I got a tip for you. Don't let no one get this close.
Oh, come on! Come on! Jake Gyllenhaal, everybody. Roadhouse begins streaming this Thursday on Prime Video. More with Jake when we come back. Stick around, everybody. Hey.